Let's start today's computer class. In the last video, we discussed about few HTML tags which we use within body tag and which are used for text formatting. Like by using those tags, we can align the text, we can make the text bold, italic, underline, we can give the different colors, we can give background colors and so on. And today we will discuss few advanced features of HTML. So let's start. HTML list. Now what is this HTML list? HTML list is used to list the content on web page. You might have observed in MS Word also, you can convert the text in form of bullets and numbering. Similarly, in HTML also, there is an option of giving bullets, different types of bullets, as well as numbered. It can be number, it can be in alphabets form, it can be in Romans, fine. So there are two different ways to display the list. First is unordered list and the second is ordered list. So first we will study about what is this unordered list. In unordered list, each item is displayed in the bullet form, fine. The entire content is enclosed in UL and closing of UL. Each item is enclosed in list item LI, and both this UL and LI are which type of tag? Container tag, because it has on tag as well as off tag. List item also container on and off tag. And which attribute we use in unordered list? What is attribute which give the extra information about the tag? So what is the attribute of UL? It's type attribute. Type means what type of, what kind of unordered list you want to make. Fine. Like what can be the value of type? Three values we can give in HTML. We can give square, we can give circle or disk. Fine. If you give the square, the bullet will be in the form of square or circle. Now what is the difference between circle or disc? Disc are usually filled circle, you can say. Fine. This is circle and these are filled circle. And by default, if you don't mention the type, still it will work. And the by default, the bullet will be disc in shape. Fine. So let's see how to use them. See, this is the example. H3. What is H3? To give the heading, I told you in the last video, to give the heading, we use how many types of heading tags are available? 6 type. Fine. H1 to H6. H1 is the largest and H6 is the smallest. Now, here I have given H3. So, this is a heading size H3, Fruits Names. And this is the heading Fruits Names. UL type equals to square. UL is unordered list and its attribute we have used type. Which type? Square. Fine. If you want the bullet in square form, then type will be square. Then the list item, whatever list item you want, it depends upon you, number of list item you can give. Fine. Here I have given 3: orange, banana, mango. Fine. Okay, and list item we will close it. If you will not close it, still it will work, but you should close the list item. Fine, because this is a container tag. Then UL closed, and when you run it, the output will look like this. H3 Fruits Name, this is the size of H3 approximate. Then orange, banana, mango, and the bullet will be your square shape. Fine. If you give here circle, then the bullet will be your circle shape. If you don't give any type, if you don't mention the type, only UL also you can give, then the shape of bullet will be disc, or you can give type equals to disc also. Fine. So 3 types are available: circle, square or disc. Now the next is ordered list. In ordered list, Each item is displayed along with the numbers or letters instead of bullets. Now these are ordered, so the content will be displayed in form of numbers or letters. The entire content of the list is enclosed in OL. OL stands for ordered list, and the closing tag of OL. Each item is enclosed in list item, same in case of unordered list. So LI and closing of LI. Type and size are the attributes used in ordered list. In DAC, we use only in unordered list, we use only type. But in ordered list, two attributes we will use, type and size. Fine. So let's see the usage of ordered list, how to use that. Example. Okay. Now the colors, names, headings, if you want to give, then I have enclosed colors name within H3. OL type equals to A. So what type of numbering you want to give? Alphabets. Fine. You want to give alphabets. So here I have given capital A. If you give small a, you can give. So value of A, value of type can be capital A, can be small a, it can be 1, 2, 3, or it can be Romans. For Romans, you will write small I. Okay, in practical, I'll show you. Fine. Now type equals to capital A. Fine. And start equals to 3. What does it mean? Start equals to 3. A, B, C. So it will start with C. If you give start equals to 5, A, B, C, D, E. So it will start with E. Fine. So here I've given 3. So that's why the list is started with C. C, D, E. Because the 3 list item I have given here. Start equals to 3 means it will start with C. Capital C. Fine. If you give here small a, then here the small c will appear. Okay. Now red, blue, yellow, 3 list items we have given. Then close the ordered list. So this is the output. Colors, names. Fine. C, D, E, red, blue, yellow. Fine. This is the output of this HTML. Now the next is, so that was about type of list. Two types of list we have discussed, ordered and unordered. And the next is marquee tag. Marquee tag, what is the use of marquee tag? Sometimes you might have observed that text is scrolling on the top of the page, or anywhere you can give. You might have observed scrolling text across the web page, or from top to bottom, or from bottom to top, and in any direction you might have observed. Fine. So how can you give that moving or animating text? By using the marquee tag. Marquee tag is used to give an extra effect to a string or a block of text. Fine. It gives the extra effect to the string or it can be a block of text. Means 2-3 sentences might be there. Fine. It is used to scroll a block of text within the web page. Fine. So it is used to scroll. So like this way it will keep on scrolling. Fine. Now what is the syntax? Syntax is very simple. Marquee, string of text, and then marquee close. Example, like string of text, learning HTML. So what you will find? You will find learning HTML block will scroll across the web browser. Fine. Now we will see the attributes of marquee tag. Two attributes we will discuss. One is direction and another is behavior. So let's see the direction first. Now, what is the use of direction attribute? It specifies the direction in which the string of text will scroll on the web page. Like the string of text scrolling in which direction? Is it from right to left, left to right, top to bottom, or bottom to top? So who will decide? This direction attribute will decide. 4 values you can assign in direction. It can be left, it can be right, it can be up, or it can be down. If you have given the value left, what does it mean? It means that the block of text will scroll towards left hand side. Fine. If you give direction equals to left, then what does it mean? The text will move from right to left. From right to left, like in this direction. From right to left. Fine. For example, how will you use it? Marquee direction equals to left. Welcome to IT world. Marquee close. So welcome to IT world. String will move from right to left. Fine. If you give the value right, it means that the block of text will scroll towards right hand side from the extreme left hand side. From left to right in this direction. Fine. Up. It means that the block of text will scroll upwards from the bottom of the web page, like this. Down, it means that the block of text will scroll downwards, up say down, fine, from the top of the web page. Like marquee direction equals to down, welcome to IT world. So four values you can assign in direction. It can be left, it can be right, or it can be up, or it can be down. Fine. Behavior. Now, second is behavior. What is the use of behavior attribute? Fine. When we use in syntax, spelling of behavior, we will use B-E-H-A-V-I-O-R. Fine. In book, U is given here, but when you use in syntax, then it will be O only, no U will be used. Fine. Here also you can use OR. Fine. But here always OR. So behavior is a part of marquee which states about the types of movements of the string or text. Earlier we have studied the direction of movement. Now we will study about types of movement, and you will decide types of movement behavior attribute. Fine. And the value of behavior can be alternate, can be scroll, or it can be slide. So three values can be assigned in behavior. It can be alternate, it can be scroll, or it can be slide. If the value of behavior is alternate, what does it mean? The text will keep on scrolling between the ends, like from left to right, then right to left, left to right, right to left. So it will keep on scrolling like this. Fine. Marquee behavior equals to alternate, learning HTML, marquee closed. Now if you give the scroll, only scroll, if you don't mention the behavior, then by default it is scroll. So what does it mean? Scroll means text keeps on scrolling across the screen and scrolls back on the web page. Like the text will start from, for example, from here, then it will go there, then it will take some time and it will come back here, not from the front side, from the back side. Fine. It will keep on going from here, then it will come from the back side, which will not be visible. After some time again it will be visible from left to from right to left. So it will keep on scrolling like this. Are you getting? Fine. Now third is slide. In practical it will be more clear. Okay, I'll show you slide. Now the third one is slide. In this attribute, string of text starts scrolling from the right hand side of the screen and stops as soon as it reaches the left hand side. It will start from the right hand side and stops when it reach at the left hand side. Fine. So this is slide. Mostly we give scroll or alternate. Fine. We don't give slide. Okay, that's it for today. We have discussed about list and marquee, very very important. In next video I'll show you the practical. Fine. So thanks for watching. Thank you, class.